Hey guys, it's gabavr, and this time I bring you some good news about the Insta360 X3 camera. This is the latest consumer model of the Insta360 series, which I recently used for 360 shooting and creating camera tricks. If you're interested about the camera and all the tips and tricks, check out my review and my tutorials in the right top corner. But until that, let's see some important new features came with the firmware update this week. First, here is a new recording feature called pre-recording. I can activate it in the settings menu and set it to 15 or 30 seconds. Then I can see on the bottom that pre-recording is active. It means it doesn't matter when I start recording, an extra 15 or 30 seconds will be recorded before that moment. It can be very useful if you are waiting for an action to happen, but you don't know exactly when it will come. But you don't have to be afraid of missing the moment, or record for long minutes without any action just for the sake of safety. In the meantime, you can find a new function in the app too, called Auto Frame. It helps you in reframing and cutting your clips, as AI does the most of the work for you, totally automatically. If you wanna learn more about this feature, check out my detailed Auto Frame tutorial in the right top corner. And talking about faster and easier post-production, let's take a look at Me Mode. This video mode helps you creating selfie videos in camera using both lenses but recording only a smaller part of the full 360 space, always following you, doesn't matter how you move on the scene. Even more, you can switch between vertical and horizontal mode with one tap, so you don't have to waste time with transforming your video afterwards. And here comes another great update which maximizes compatibility when you wanna mix these clips with other video sources, because the new firmware supports any frame rates you need. You can shoot Me Mode videos with 25 fps, or in Slo-Mo with 50 fps, or with 30 or 60 fps depending on your country. Even more, you can match your clips to other cinematic shots with 24 fps, or even in Slo-Mo switching to 48 fps. So now we got the full range of frame rate options for any case, and fortunately this type of upgrade affects further shooting modes too. So now we can select 24, 25 and 50 besides 30 or 60 fps in 4K mode, which is a good news especially if you wanna shoot in slow-mo or manual bullet time in any frame rates. And if you're looking for an extreme 100 fps slow-mo, you can find a new 3K 100 fps mode, which did exist in the original 1X and 1X2, but has been missing in X3 until now. So as you can see, there are some really cool and essential upgrades in the latest firmware. I think pre-recording can be very useful in many cases, while having a full range of frame rates in all the recording modes gives us more flexibility and compatibility, doesn't matter how we wanna use our X3 clips. If you have any further questions about these updates, leave a comment below. And if you like this short summary, please hit the like button. And for further 360 contents and tutorials, subscribe to my channel. And see you next time.